A national seminar and they formulated the guidelines, but finally the government department woke up. Ministry of Environment and Climate Change came out with a formal guidelines of environmental and management of C&D waste in 29/3/2016. From then onwards, we have a lot of information coming up on construction and demolition waste. Well, friends, demolition, construction demolition waste is okay, but how to deconstruct a building, that is also very important. Whereas systematically, if you deconstruct, then recycling will be very easy. So we have a Hong Kong model, which is acceptable as far as the Indian standards is concerned. But the GIS, which is a German company, has brought out a code of practice for demolition. And recently, National Institute of Technology Karnataka Surutkal has submitted a very detailed guidelines for deconstruction, and which is accepted by ILFS, and they have brought out a manual also, which is available in the net. Friends, now we engineers and builders, we need codes also. Well, BIS codes IS 383 is permitting the use of recycled aggregates up to 25% in a plain concrete, 20% in M25 concrete, and lean concrete you can use up 100% also. That's one gateway of opening. National Building Code was also opened, and we have which can be used in our regular construction, regular building products. What are the products? I'll get back to you. But what is the composition of these demolition waste? This might be varieties of items. The percentage is given there. Well, but the guidelines issued by the MOEF, which says if a person, well, the first sentence is very clear. Who is a waste generator? It's all we, you, everybody who does construction. Well, where 20% and above, they are called 20 tons per day or 300 kilo tons per month. If you are producing a construction waste, then you are called as a bulk generator. Once you are identified as a bulk generator, then you have your own setup. We have your own set of guidelines where the government insists that you have to give a demolition plan, you have to give a disposal plan, etc. You have to segregate and do a lot of things. When, okay, on protecting environment, we are the ninth place, which were issued very recently by the Climate Change Performance Index, but we need to go up in the standard. Well, construction waste, if you processed, we are getting wonderful materials. We get coarse aggregate, we get fine aggregate, we get manufactured soil. Well, that explains everything. Once you get coarse aggregate, fine aggregate, manufactured soil, we can recast the entire construction material and put to use it. And we can save the dump yards, and other construction materials can also be saved. You know, sand mining is not allowed, and nowadays granite mining also might get a ban very soon. What happens? Well, the government has taken action. We have a wonderful model in Delhi. Delhi Burari Park and Shastri Park are the wonderful models to emulate. And all the things are coming up in other cities also. A lot of things are coming up in Bombay and Bangalore and many other places. Well, if you... Now the study has been done. So what are the quantities of recycled... or what are the quantities of C&D waste per tons per day based on the calculations? Let's not go into this. Let's see what are the uses of the demolition waste. Well, where are we standing in the world? Just go through this, my dear friends. You will realize we have a long way to go. See, Germany having 220 plants, and UK has 120 plants, France has 50 plants, Italy has 43 plants, Netherlands and Belgium has 60 plants for 7 million tons per year. So, and we are still at hardly handling numbers, counting finger counts, factories are there or the generating units are there. Well, now, who has to do this? Now, what is our role? Selective deconstruction, all builders and engineers has to see that the selective deconstruction do happen, on-site aggregation will happen, on-site downsizing will happen, then effective disposal or recycling can be happen. If you don't do that, if you dump it straight away, it's going to be an environmental issue. Well, the waste generator, that's what they say, let's go. This explains very clearly how a big mammoth demolition construction site has to have. we should have a lot of equipments are there, we have segregation there, we have a lot of segregation units are there, and once it is segregated, it is taken to the top circle, and I'm not able to pointer, sorry. Well, on the top circle, we have the trucks coming up, and once it has come, it has been taken into the recycling unit. But how does the recycling unit? Let me explain to you. This is how generally a recycled aggregate looks like. And the recycled sand or the yam sand, it is as good as the same original sand, but there will be a little bit difference because a lot of the mortar and will be added to that. You need to have a proper mix design to get the right amount of compressive strength of your product. All these materials can be manufactured. I have seen in my own eyes that all this can be manufactured very easily, and you can hardly make out whether this is manufactured using a recycled aggregate or not. Well, and a lot of equipments are available. This is the first model which the entire country can emulate, which is the Murari model of New Delhi. ILFS is the heading it, and they are now having a lot of units in nearby cities. They are also coming to Chennai, they are on Indore, Rajkot, and things are happening. Government of circular has been issued by the government of India that C&D waste recycling has to happen. Well, these are all the benefits which I will not explain to you right now. This is a typical model of a recycling plant. What you generally need is, you need around 5 acres of land, a minimum. 10 to 15 acres is wonderful. Then you can have a wonderful recycling unit for a target period of 20 to 25 years. Well, on the top, the materials will be dumped and it will be segregated. And once it is crushed, it will be brought down and so on. I'll explain to you with the different model here. This is the Shastri Park one, which is a very mammoth one. And they proclaim that around 36 lakh tons of C&D waste since inception on 2009, they have recycled and contributed to the environment. Well, this is at Mumbai. Mumbai, what happens? On the top, they've got a wonderful platform where the natural gradient has allowed them to have a platform on the top where the construction and demolition waste are dumped on the top. From the top, it has been crushed. And whatever is crushed and it's fine, they come down. And then it is taken down and it has been recycled as an aggregate. But whatever is not able to recycle or crush to the desired size, doesn't pass through the sieve, required sieve, it is again taken down and recycled again back to the first place. And again, it is given into the sieve crusher. It is crushed first, then it is washed. And then once it is washed, then it is passed through a sieve, and passing the sieve, suppose you want a 10 mm granite metal, you get 10 mm metal. If you put a sieve of 20 mm, you get 20 mm granite metal. And this is my hand only. This is the C&D waste granite metal. I could not make out at the first sight. Then if you watch very closely, then you can see a little bit of cement mortar particles are added to it. So on detailed discussion, construction and demolition waste, if used 100%, probably the cost will go a little bit high because you need to add a little bit of extra cement, and it has to be the mix design has to be done for your desired strength. This is the construction and demolition waste on the top, where the officials from the Godrej, they go there, they visit and select the demolition waste, and once it is segregated, the owner has to pay for the transportation and it is being dumped in this place. Actually, Government of India guidelines say that even the processing fees shall be paid by the developer or the demolisher. Well, and these are the products they manufacture there. And this is the material being stocked there. They can manufacture with partial replacement or with 100% replacement. Well, we have different models in India where a large amount of demolition is being taken up, and we have a wonderful expertise. We have the equipments where the Setu model is the Mahatma Gandhi Setu model in Patna was demolished, and not a single drop of construction waste was dropped into the Ganga River. And all these equipments now are available in India. We have a lot of dealers who deal with all these major equipments, and we have consultants also who can consult, who can give you based on your design of the site and the condition, location, can give you a map how a recycling waste plant can be executed. Well, the school building at Rajkot, designed by Ahmedabad-based architect Surya Kakani, was one of the wonderful model. Then we have a wonderful model in Gurgaon, that is IRRAD building. And there are other models also. These are the different models available. Now we have mobile models also. They come to your site. It can be brought to your site for segregation, for crushing, segregation purpose. There are different models available now. Just go through it. And now Government of India issues guidelines. That's very nice. And Delhi government has issued that 2% has to be used in the on your road work, 10% on your road work, and local urban authorities has to use 5% in the road work. It's all is fine. But we as a builder, as a developer, or as an entrepreneur, what are the benefits we get? Well, it's very, government incentive is still on the paper only. 100 smart cities, all the 100 smart cities have planned that they should have construction demolition waste. None of them are yet to see the light of the day. And government is supposed to give us free land, and but that is not, in a gazette order has not yet come. We had approached our electrical department for MESCOM for providing us at least subsidized or free current, because we are ready to recycle the waste and protect the environment, but they say we don't have any guidelines. And corporation, finally the corporation said we'll give you 2 acres of land. I said 2 acres of land is not at all enough. Minimum of 5 acres land is needed, because you need to plan for next 10 to 25, or at least for next 25 years. So these are different guidelines issued by the government. It's still on the paper, yet to see the day of the light. Friends, we have futuristic machines coming up. This is one of the machines which can eat concrete directly and give you aggregates right at the site itself. At one time processing, you need not have any crusher, or you not have any other equipments. Well, this is pretty costly. And in Bangalore, well, they have estimated that it is 1,000 to 3,000 tons per day, but they have not yet really acted upon where the real construction demolition waste has unit has to start working. This unit has to be such a way that what Delhi model it works out, it is in a particular area. City Corporation or the Delhi Metropolitan Authority, they insist that you have to pay so much of fees for your demolition waste. And the demolition waste at the cost of the builder is transported to a particular place. And from there, it has been lifted and taken into the ILFS recycling plant. There it is recycled. And for the builders, for them, it is given at around 10% discounted, because they are giving the processing fees also. So that works out. That means to say the corporation, the builder, and the local people, builders, to work together, then we can contribute to our nature. Well, there is one classic example. In Belgium, there is one resort which was totally built with construction and demolition debris. And this is one of the classic example. My dear friends, one thing we have to keep in mind, being a builder or being a citizen of this country, that we need nature. Nature doesn't need us. So it's our duty. Nature can survive without us, but we cannot survive without nature at all. So it's our duty now that we should do something. So we should start doing recycling at the earliest. So thank you very much. I'm ready to take any questions, if any, or later. Thank you.
Absolutely wonderful lecture. Thank you, Rajendra. Absolutely wonderful. And there's so much to learn about C&D waste. We never knew that there was so much to it. We just thought that it was just waste dumped on the road. But